Hello, my friends. A very good morning to you. Today, I'm going to present to you a video that is on supercomputers and human brains. I'm going to talk to you about some of the best supercomputers available in this world and then discuss about its value in front of our human brains. But before I go to the video, I would like to request you to kindly do subscribe to our channel and press the bell button for latest update. So now let's move to our video on supercomputers and human brains. In 2011, top 500 project committee announced arrival of fastest supercomputer developed by Fujitsu in 2011. The name of the computer was K-computer. K in Japanese means 10 quadrillion. In fact, K-computer was the first computer to cross the benchmark of 10 petaflops. So 10 petaflops means 10 quadrillion computations per second. In simple terms, it means capacity of almost 1 million desktops combined in one single computer. So, with this massive, powerful supercomputer, Japan has been using it not only for its defense purposes, but it has also used these computers very smartly for climate research and disaster prevention. In addition, it is being used in medical research and other human related activities, which is helping Japan in reaching out to its own citizen in a much better way with more better healthcare and more better information. 2 years later, China developed a much faster supercomputer than what Japanese has developed. So the name of this new supercomputer was Tiane 2, which was 3 times faster than the supercomputer called K-computer developed by Japan. For developing this supercomputer Tiane 2, 1300 scientists and engineers worked together in China to develop this 3 times faster supercomputer than K-computer. And just 3 years after, China developed much faster supercomputer than Tiane 2. In fact, they developed 3 times faster computer called TaihuLight in June 2016. And the company that developed this supercomputer was called Sunway. So while developing fastest supercomputers of the world, China has developed its capabilities in developing more high quality computers. So currently, China is the owner of more than top 200 supercomputers of the world. So China has dominated the supercomputers market from 2012 till June 2018. But it doesn't mean that it was only China that has developed so many supercomputers with high capabilities. The reality is US as well as the Western world have in fact taken lead much before Chinese or Japanese. The supercomputers of NASA is well known for its innovation and its capabilities. Similarly, supercomputer called Jugene from Germany is known for its mathematical capabilities and other scientific capabilities that it has. In Italy, scientists and research organizations and universities combined together to create a consortium called Cineca, and Cineca has produced world top supercomputers, namely Fermi and Marconi. And again, in US, there are several companies and research organizations that have developed supercomputers. For example, Oak Ridge is one of them from US. Therefore, the supremacy which China had maintained from year 2012 till 2018 was again broken by US when IBM announced arrival of its new supercomputer called Summit in June 18. Summit, in its normal capacity, has 122 petaflops calculation capacity, which is almost 30% higher than the capacity of TaihuLight from China, which had capacity of 93 petaflops. And also, Summit, when it is giving its peak performance, gives almost double performance than TaihuLight of China. That means Summit has its peak performance of 200 petaflops. This converts to 2 times higher capacity than TaihuLight of China. So before we discuss about the power of our brains, let's also understand the capabilities of Summit, the fastest supercomputer of the world available today. Summit has been developed by IBM on behalf of US Department of Energy. Summit is located at Oak Ridge National Laboratory, Tennessee. US government spent $200 million to develop the Summit through IBM. And the speed of Summit is 200 petaflops. It covers an area of 2 basketball courts. Interestingly, it has a very complex nature of network of cables inside its body that amounts to total of 136 miles of cabling, and the total weight of this supercomputer is 340 tons. While it has diverse use, it is actively being used in cosmology, medicine, and climatology. Also, it is being used in developing many applications, especially through machine learning in the areas like energy physics and human health. In simple terms, it is being used in scientific research like designing chemical formula, exploring new materials, study of links between cancer and genes on a large scale, investigating fusion energy, researching universe through astrophysics, and simulating Earth climate. These are certain areas where we humans could not reach because we had no approach nor we had the capabilities to assimilate such a massive scale of data and analyze them. But now, through use of supercomputer called Summit and alike other ones, scientists are now exploring in a big way our universe, physics, astrophysics, chemicals, materials, genes, and their relations with humans. So this way, supercomputer is helping us reach out to those sections where humans could not reach before. So friends, now we know United States owns the world's fastest supercomputer called Summit with 200 petaflops calculation speed. This means this supercomputer has the combined capacity of more than 1 million fastest laptops in a single unit. However, it is interesting to note that in last 70 years of developmental history of the computers and supercomputers, we have not been able to surpass the calculation speed of the human mind, which is estimated at 1000 petaflops of calculation speed per second. Just imagine the strength of the human brain. Let us now imagine the nature's wonder that every human is bestowed with. On an average, a human brain has 1300 to 1400 grams of weight. It has a length of 16.5 centimeters and width of 14 centimeters and the height of 90 centimeters. But this small dimension of our brain hosts 86 billion neurons that empower the brain. This makes us one of the most intelligent species on the earth. This further compels us to understand our own strength. We should be proud of the capabilities we have in our brain, and we must work towards using these capabilities for harnessing new possibilities available for each one of us. This means we should work constructively by solving complex problems for the betterment of humankind, as we have a brain that is 5 times more powerful than the world's top supercomputers. Hello friends, thanks for watching this video. Hope you liked it. If you liked it, please do comment and share. Also, to inform you, we are working on another video on artificial intelligence and human values, which is very important for future of humanity. If you like to get the latest updates, do subscribe to our channel and press the bell button. Till then, goodbye and adios.